Hello and welcome to Heavy Metal, Battletech Heavy Metal Advanced 3062, where we combine the Heavy Metal DLC for Battletech along with the Advanced 3062 mod. We've had some great adventures so far, so we're looking forward to jump right back into the action here. We've traveled to Kern for a travel mission, which we have to take before we do anything else. So this is a target acquisition mission. So we have to pick our lance very carefully here. So we want to do mechs that have a decent amount of speed combined with firepower. It's a tough balancing act. It's also in the Badlands, so we have to keep heat in mind here. I think we're going to take our Wolverine, our Kentaro. Our Crusader. For the firepower, it's very hard to beat. And we're going to take our Wolfhound, because our Wolfhound has obviously quite a bit of speed to it. So we need to make the most . Okay, so we have some new pilots here, so I'm going to try to train them up as well. We'll try to get them into the mix. So we got two new pilots, or pilots that I'm training up into the mix. One of the things you'll see here is this mod lets you do an auto succeed if they think that your mission is not going to be a problem, but I don't like to do that because you don't get to pick the salvage that you get. And in addition to a payday, we also want to get that sweet salvage. So sometimes you just have to grind. And one thing about the Advanced 3062 mod is there's so many different mechs available. It's a total different environment. You never know what mechs you're going to get on a typical mission. The skulls really don't tell you that much about what you're going to get theoretically, or there's a higher variance than with regular Battletech. Also, there's so many different mechs you can get. For example, you can get royal equivalents of certain mechs, which means that they're maxed out with lost tech and they're completely different than their traditional version, even though they have the same tonnage. So all those things are factors when you're looking at salvage. Sometimes I take mechs that have less tonnage, but I know that they're a higher quality variant than the higher tons. For example, let's say if you have a primitive Banshee, or you have an advanced, Jagger Mech 2. The truth is, you probably want to get the Jagger Mech 2, even though the Banshee might have a lot more tonnage. That's just a good example. So we're prepping for combat here. So the target acquisition missions, as you know, their speed is a big factor. You have a limited window to secure the points that you need to get the target lock for the cannons, but you also want to... You can't go into these missions with just, say, locusts and expect to really be successful. Or you could probably beat it, but you're probably going to take some damage. You're probably not going to get a lot of salvage. Interface initiated. All right. we got to get target locks on all three of these points. We're actually located pretty well as a start.
I hear you.
So what we're going to do is we're going to take our fastest mech, which is the Wolfhound, and we're going to send the Wolfhound after the farthest location. Oh, we got a Warhammer 7S. That's an interesting mech for sure. Look at those weapons. This is exactly what I'm talking about. I have a Warhammer already, but this Warhammer is maxed out. As you can see, it's got ERPPCs, it's got medium pulses, it's got SRM streak. That is one heck of a Warhammer.
Tell me what you're doing.
This thing hard.
Here it comes.
From the get-go. There's gonna be some good salvage on that thing. Oh, a Marauder. Okay. Really nice salvage already on this mission. Now we might be under-tunned. But I've got really nice weaponry on the mechs that I've taken. Especially the Kentaro, because it's the Royal variant. So, this ain't your mama's Wolverine even either. You got lots of upgraded weapons on there. Thunderbolt 7M, again, another upgraded mech, if I'm not mistaken. Once I could target it, I could confirm that. So, yes, we want to achieve our objective here, but we also want to get some nice salvage here. Crusader.
Roger.
We should get a full salvo, hopefully, at least of the missiles into this Warhammer. So we need to take out that leg in particular. Okay.
Reporting critical hit.
That leg's in bad shape there. Okay. Alright, so we're going to want to keep the Wolfhound sprinting through. Best thing I can do here actually is use an active probe. So we can get locks on all of these enemy mechs. Really a no-brainer here. We're going to go for knockdown on this Warhammer.
Scored a critical hit.
Okay. Star is going to come in for melee on our Grasshopper, which is exactly really what we want here.
Minor damage, Commander. Nothing to see here.
That actually falls into the best case scenario. Warhammer down. We're going to switch targets. Try to hit this Thunderbolt hard. As you can see, that weapon, this Thunderbolt M7, has a lot of lost tech on it as well. So there's going to be some good components available for salvage here. Spot because this Marauder came in for melee on a Grasshopper. Oh, miss. Highly unusual. But a Marauder against a Grasshopper in melee is not something that the Crusade, that the Marauder's gonna win very often. I love the Marauder. But it's not. It's not, it has decent melee, but it's really not as good as you'd like to think. Let's go for the head on this Warhammer here, see if we can finish it out. We're probably going to do so much damage to destroy the engine. Yeah, that's unfortunate. We should still get some good components out of that, though. Now we got some vehicles that are going to be pumping out on a regular basis.
Commander?
All right. And this is a situation where we've got a rear shot on this Challenger, and it's got two Gauss rifles on it, so we can probably take that out as quickly as possible. Wow, that thing's got a lot of armor, even on the rear. That's going to be challenging. Alright, keep moving the Wolfhound down to the farthest target. Do some damage to the Thunderbolts on the way by. From that Marauder.
Light damage. Holding firm.
Standing by.
Alright. Again, same situation here. We've got this Challenger here that's got two Gauss rifles on it. We do not want this thing to turn around and start shooting at us.
On top.
Necessary evil there. Alright, some shots on our Grasshopper. We can handle that. Thunderbolt's gonna use some Ace Pilot. Marauder doesn't have any evasion now, so we're going to go back to melee against the Marauder. Nice structure exposure there. A bunch of medium lasers right into the gap. Or small lasers right into the gap.
Good to go.
Same situation here. We've got a demolisher with dual AC-20s, so that's actually the bigger threat than the Thunderbolt right now. Let's just take that off the board.
Reporting. Vehicle destroyed.
Waiting on you, Commander.
down so he can get lock on that more distant target.
Receiving you.
Alright, looks like we might have a round away free of vehicles. So let's use our Royal Kentaro to hit this Thunderbolt. On its way to that other targeting point.
Ready for orders.
Sprint. The Wolverine. So next round we could get someone into that point. Gotta watch our heat here. Took out some of the key weapons there. Alright, Marauder switched targets to the Grasshopper. Grasshopper's got plenty of armor to handle that. So we're just going to go in for melee again. Each time the Marauder shoots at us, instead of moving, it's putting itself in a position where it has no evasion. And we're just going to slowly, we're going to eventually grind this thing down.
Critical hit, Commander.
Thunderbolt goes for melee. Makes sense since it's lost a lot of its weapons.
I'm showing minor damage. Commander? Roger. Full speed.
One of the legs on the Thunderbolt here. Heat is going to continue to be a problem.
Target taken a critical hit.
Alright, we made it into a pogo stick. Our objective and still get some fire in on the Thunderbolt. We can actually do precision strike here, see if we can get knocked down. He'll eject shortly. And he's one injury away from being incapacitated. Alright, let's get our Wolfhound into the circle.
Waiting for orders.
We just try to go for the head here so we can scare this guy into ejecting. No, destroyed the engine. Well, we tried. So the Marauder actually did something pretty smart here. It put itself in a position where we can't get melee.
Right, Commander.
But the grass. Grasshopper still has a lot of firepower. So let's just go for knockdown here. So where's our evac point? All right, so our evac point is over there.
Waiting for orders.
So.
Double flight, next goal. What can I do for you?
Back point as quickly and as safely as we can here.
Yes, Commander.
Oh, we got some vehicles that came out. All
right. Roger. Full speed.
So we got a demolisher and another challenger. So, assuming the challenger, yep, challenger has Gauss rifles again. So we got to make sure we take that thing out quickly. Move towards the evac point and still stay away from that orbital strike.
Commander?
Alright, so this is a problem because we got.
Got it.
We got these vehicles. So that's our best chance to do some damage. Okay, demolisher's gonna turn. So we're gonna have to deal with these vehicles now. Dual AC-20. Some of these vehicles just are crazy overpowered. Alright, so we need to sprint out. Targets the mechs we can. Get away from these, from this artillery fire.
Waiting on you, Commander.
Let's see, can we get close enough with the Wolfhound to help with an active probe?
I've got a sensor lock.
All right, that helps a little. One thing we can do is try to do some melee on this demolisher. Not quite enough. Dual Gauss rifle is going to be a problem. Crusader,
away
from the impact zone, can at least provide some support on the challenger here. That thing is a beast.
Here to go.
All right, let's go for the short kill.
On my way.
On the demolisher. Hopefully the challenger will be within the impact zone of that Calendar should be taken out here by that strike. Very nice, very fortunate. Evac zone as quickly as possible.
I hear you.
We don't have pesky reinforcements. We probably have more than enough salvage opportunities here, so there's no reason to stay and fight.
Receiving.
Now we can actually sprint through the facility now that it's been destroyed.
Waiting for orders.
So we'll do that. Simple target acquisition mission. Should have some good salvage opportunities.
Mission successful.
Should have some Gauss rifles available. Should have some, hopefully some lost tech weapons. And depending on how many parts of that Warhammer we got, we might be able to do something a little tricky. Because that was a really nice Warhammer. Yeah, we only got one part of it. Two parts of the Marauder. Not the best Marauder. I am going to take the Warhammer part because if I can get some more like it, then we're going to have some advantages. Ooh, C3 Masters. There's lots of good technology here, so probably I should take this C3 Master because those are so valuable. Look at all the Gauss rifles we have here. We got medium pulse. Ooh, we got an engine core that's 300. Kind of have to take that. So many things to take here. Double heat sink, XL engine. I think we have to take the XL engine here. Luckily, we've got lots of extra parts that we can get here, so got a couple AC-20s, we can sell those. We got a Gauss rifle, probably sell that at this point. E-cooling plus 2, that's nice. XL engine. Not the best salvage for this mission, but is what it is. We got paid a fair amount of money, and we needed to travel anyway, so I love that message on the top. If you can see it, Darius has no idea what he's talking about half the time. That's absolutely true. Darius either tells me things that I've already figured out, or he tells me things way too late. Like, you just get hit in the back a couple times with a PPC, and then they say, oh, by the way, there's enemy reinforcements. Thanks. Thanks for telling me there's enemy reinforcements after they shoot me in the back. All right, let's stop by the barracks.
Receiving you. Waiting for orders.
Cold fire here. Just getting some nice upgrades. Job, Coldfire. I picked him up when we traveled. It's worked out pretty well.
Mech Warrior training complete.
Here they go.
Pinky.
Training confirmed, Commander.
For our pilots. Stop by the mech bay. What do we got repairs wise? So the only thing we had that had damage was the grasshopper, but it was deemed to be so low that they gave us the repair for free. So no damage to deal with there. We can actually go right into the next mission here. There's actually some pretty good missions here on this planet. We'll get one more in on this video. Okay, ambush colony, convoy, no. You know I hate those. Assassination. Flushing them out. That's usually a good opportunity for some good salvage. Test drive the Jagger Mech 2. Yeah, let's take this one. Because we actually can use somebody else's mech. Now, ironically, I already have a Jagger Mech 2, as you can see in the mech bay here. So it's not so much, not really that exciting to test drive the Jagger Mech, right? Because I already have one. Let's see, this is a 3.5 skull mission. Let's see, I want to mix things up a little bit here. I did pick up this Royal Marauder, and I want to take it for a test drive. So this would be a good mission for that. So this Royal Marauder, again, as I've said, anytime with a mod that you find a Royal variant, you want to maximize salvage on that variant. So as you can see here, we've got some ER meat PPCs, which came with it. I've added a medium laser plus. I threw in a Gauss rifle. It came with an AC-5, but I upgraded that for a Gauss rifle. Another ER PPC and another medium laser plus. But as you can see, it also has double heat sinks. This is not like your mother's Marauder. This is a very nice weapon, especially with that Gauss rifle with a sniper pilot. We should probably get some good chances for headshots with that. So I want to try that one out. I also love my Perseus missile boat, so let's take that. I'm also enjoying the Crusader, actually, to be honest with you. For its tonnage, I really like the firepower. It's a little short on armor, so you gotta play it smart, but I really like the Crusader. And we'll take our Wolfhound as our bonus pilot. Yeah, we'll put Coldfire in there because we want to keep leveling him up. Let's put Pinky. Mickey in the Crusader? And here we go. So this would be a more exciting mission if I didn't already have a Jagger Mech 2. I mean, that's one fun way when you get these try out X piece of equipment. It's always a fun mission because you never know. It's like, ooh, it's a new toy that I could try out. And if I break it, as long as it doesn't get destroyed, it's no big deal. But since I already have a Jagger Mech 2, I picked it up in salvage off camera. It's really not so exciting. In fact, my Jagger Mech that I have in my mech bay is probably better than the Jagger Mech that we're going to be test driving. But that's fine. These are usually pretty quick missions. Usually it'll be a situation where we're either fighting one lance and then reinforcements come, or we're fighting a lance and then a rival lance will come in. So you end up, basically we're going to end up fighting two lances here. Good salvage opportunities. And we're actually getting pretty decent pay for the fact that we're getting 4 and 18 salvage. So this will be the last mission for this video. Just a quick video today. The Jagger Mech. The Jagger Mech is a mech that is so close to being a great mech. You want to love it because it's got that AC firepower. But the armor is a problem. The speed is a problem. If you play the Jagger Mech in Mech Warrior 5, for example, it's very powerful, but it's also very fragile. So, you know, it's close to being a really good mech. If they had made the Jagger Mech, now the Jagger Mech 2 is an extra 5 tons, but if they had made a Jagger Mech 3 that was like 90 tons, so you could really put some powerful ACs on it, then that would be exciting.
I hear you.
Alright, so where's our targets? Okay. Alright, so let's actually sprint up with our Wolfhound. We're going to save our active probe.
Waiting for
orders. So we got our Royal Marauder. So what I actually want to do is, if we can get the high ground here, it's going to be the perfect spot for our Royal Marauder and our Jagger Mech to get some nice headshots. If I could get them up here and draw the enemy towards that cliff, we'll be in good shape. Alright, we got a vehicle. Hover tank. Wow, that's a lot of medium lasers on a hover tank. It's a laser boat, basically. As you can see, it also has some Inferno missiles. We've got Trebuchet 7M. 7 series typically have some higher components in it.
Receiving you.
So that's definitely nice to see. Alright, so we got our Jagger Mech.
Aye, aye.
Move the Jagger Mech drag them back up. Alright. Not the best hit percentage on that trebuchet, because it's so far away. So let's just take the shots on this missile boat here. Those UAC-5s. Very solid. Now one thing we can do here is we do have our Perseus, which is our missile boat, with 70 LRMs. Now watch this. So we've got our normal LRMs ammo, but if I switch this to Artemis, the hit percentage is not great per se, but it's still double what it would be without it, so that this actually makes this shot viable.
What can I do for you? Got it. Max speed, no shooting.
Do multi-target here, unfortunately. So we're gonna save our LRMs and just go after this hover tank.
Another hit like that, and you're in
trouble. Oh, here we go. Inbound blip. That was coming. Either way, let's get to the high ground. Not the best shots here, so we'll just take them. Ooh, nice hit with the Gauss rifle. It's a nice surprise. To finish off this initial group as fast as we can, because we got another. Let's not use active probe here. Let's just see if we can't finish off this hover tank. Maybe if we actually hit them. There we go. All right. So now we know that there's the original targets. There are four. We're gonna sprint up.
Got it.
Trying to get the high ground with our snipers here. And as you can see, this trebuchet has lost evasion because it didn't move last turn. So let's actually just go for the head here. Nice headshots there. Oh, we destroyed the engine. Okay. Alright, so there's the landing zone for the enemy lance, which is going to come in, which is great. It's actually set up very nicely for our snipers. Right, hopefully we're not frozen. Alright, there we go. The enemy's moving. So there's an enemy that's way out there.
I hear you.
Not sure what's happening there. But in the meantime, we need to set up to hit this lance when it lands as hard as possible. So whenever you have an enemy lance land on land, they basically have one turn where their accuracy is very poor, which is usually why you'll find that they'll just spread out, and embrace, because their hit chances are so low. So what we're going to do is some, what do we got here? We got a blackjack, ramshackle, we've got an assassin, and we have a shadowhawk here. So,
yeah, commander.
All these mechs. So as you can see here, right, so we get here. These guys are in bad shape. And we get nice shots to the back. Let's do precision strikes. Here we can actually finish these guys off super quick. The Shadowhawk has an Ultra 5, which is, would be good salvage. Alright, there goes one of the targets. Saying that there's 20.
Waiting on you, Commander.
Alright, so again. And these guys are really facing us to the rear. I mean, they're just like gift wrapped this lance to just have us completely salvage them by shooting them in the back.
Here it comes!
Two?
You're dead.
Now it says the local government forces are 4, but I only see 3. Hopefully that's not like a glitch. That would be frustrating. Vehicle and a mech out there. We'll have to track those down after we finish off this enemy lance. Now my big concern is there's a glitch here because it says there's 5 enemy. Oh, there's 2 blackjacks. That's why. Duh. They're standing so close to each other, I missed it. As you can see here, they just kind of brace because they've got really bad hit percentages because they just landed.
No shooting, just running.
Alright, so our employers wanted to see how awesome these Jagger mechs are. So let's do that. Strike on the head here.
I copy.
Not quite.
Inflicted some heavy damage.
What's that, boss?
Alright, we got our missile boat here. We're gonna keep our missile boat away from enemy here, but there's no reason we can't shoot LRM-70 in this blackjack's face.
What can I do for you?
Crusader. Bad hit percentages here, but why not? We'll just shoot everything. Precision strike here on the head. Alright, lethal damage. So we could put that blackjack together. Now you would say, why would I put that blackjack together? Because that blackjack actually has some double heat sinks. It looks like it actually has some good components. So it might be worth putting it together just to strip it down and then sell it. We'll see what else we have available.
Got it.
That original vehicle we need to take out. And there should be another enemy mech out there. There it is. It's a 45 tonner. We'll take care of those once we finish off these blackjacks. Or that one last blackjack, I should say. Let our employer get their money's worth by finishing off this blackjack. Heat is a problem. So that blackjack is, I mean, the Jagger mech that we're testing is really slow, so we'll let him finish off that blackjack. Alright, so we got a Drillson and another blackjack. Alright, so let's just hit that blackjack with the last of our Artemis LRMs. Didn't strike on this Drillson. Not too bad, getting in range. Move up our Wolfhound.
Going turbo.
Heat is really becoming a problem. Blackjack is trying to get out of dodge, but he can't outrun LRM. So we gotta switch to our regular missiles, not Artemis. Bad hit percentage here, but that's okay.
On that one.
see what the melee is on the Jagger mech.
Yeah.
So let's just give that a try. Oh, there goes that blackjack.
One less target.
All part of the testing,
right?
Right,
Commander.
That vehicle.
Knock out a vehicle. Mech warriors, show them what you got.
Alright, Colt fire. Let's get in there. See if we can finish this guy off.
Max beam, no shooting.
Forward.
Waiting for orders. Copy that.
Let's see if we can. Finish this blackjack off. Our last fight in this video. If you want to tap out to go to the next video, if you're just here for fighting, then feel free to do so. We get a bonus for our payout. Let's see what we can do about maxing out our salvage here. Alright, so we got a whole lot of Black Shack parts. Got a trebuchet part. Plus medium lasers, some plus small lasers, SRM2 streaks, UAC5. That's not bad, but I have a ton of those already. We got some double heat sinks. Alright, so let me show you what I was talking about before. So this So this blackjack two is actually has some double heat sinks, it's got some upgraded things. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take two parts for the blackjack two. And then we're gonna take the blackjack 1B part, because we could put those together and we could get a pretty decent blackjack. Not that we want to have the blackjack, but I can put it together, I could strip out the good stuff, and then I could sell what's left. So that's probably what we're going to do here. Let me see if I can show you what I'm talking about. Really quickly to end this video.
Hi.
So really quickly before we go here, things. I'm actually going to take this Warhammer. I'm going to put it in storage. Because I'm not really using that Warhammer. Let me just show you really quickly what I was talking about with Blackjack. So, right, so this Blackjack 2, we got two parts of this, but we can actually take that other part, pay a little premium, and we can get it put together as the Blackjack 2. And let's show you quickly what's in the Blackjack 2. So, what do we have here? So we got a double heatsink kit, we've got some double heatsinks, we've got ER large lasers, we got SRM2 streaks. So what we can do here is we can quickly put that into storage, which means we get all those components. Right, so we get all those higher end weapons, we get the double heat sinks, we get everything virtually for free. And then if we go to the store, there's the Blackjack, so we get $1 million in C bills, plus we get all of that free high end components. So that's really just one that I wanted to show you, that all salvage is not the same. And that's going to do this for this video. So we'll see you soon. And please subscribe to our channels. Talk to you later. Bye.